I am Prince of Darkness, and I intend to bring forth heaven on earth and release everyone from bondage.
The greatest spell ever told that opened the book of life. And it was about eternal life and your family's eternal life and whoever else you could get out of here. Coming back and getting them out of this matrix hell that Yahweh created. It wasn't about coming back and taking over Yahweh's creation and benefiting those who are keeping us here. What does the Bible say about the 144,000? Does it say there's just 144,000 names in the Book of Life and that's it? No, it doesn't. It says they are going to be sent out to bring sinners to Jesus Christ, to God. Why would they bring sinners? That's hypocrisy. Why would they bring sinners to God before Satan's reign, during Satan's reign, and before the day of the Lord? The day of judgment, when he's going to judge all the sinners. Why would they bring sinners to God? No, they're going to bring people who made an atonement for their sins with blood of intent. So there's no telling how many it's going to be. It's just however many we can get. I mean, you get to bring your children. You know, they don't have to make an atonement for their sins. And whoever, all the children we can get. I mean, if you think you're going to take them away from their parents, I don't know. But there's no telling how many people we can get out of here. It just depends on who, you know, what happens, on who we can show the truth and get to make an atonement for their sins. You're still going to have to make an atonement for your sins to get out of hell during Satan's reign. And that's what they're doing. They're not bringing sinners. They're bringing people who have made an atonement for their sins. It says it right there. This is called eschatology. The study of future events. And we know Satan hasn't reigned yet. And we know we haven't gone there and come back yet to get people. And we know the day of the Lord is after that. So, I don't know. It fits like a puzzle to me. And nowhere does it say in the Bible that Satan comes here and takes ownership of this world. It says, after the first 3.5 years, that Antichrist will make himself known. Well, yeah, that's what we're doing. Because they're not even going to know that we're getting people out of here. And then it's known. And then the latter half, everyone finally figures it out. Kind of like the 100th monkey thing. Everybody figures out what's going on. And then that's when war starts. And that's when heaven will be upon earth. And we will be getting people out of here during that time, during the 7 years. You're going to be a superhero coming out to save lives. Satan's Legion of Superheroes. It's hypocrisy. It's hypocrisy. And that's how you know it's a lie. It doesn't match. Just like Satan being Samuel being the venom angel of death of God, but then being the Antichrist as well. It's just hypocrisy. And that's when you know it's a lie. Samuel wrote, the Demiurge was named Samuel by the Holy Spirit, Sophia. He created this material world. He is has the body of a serpent and the head of a lion. He's the beast. They call Satan the beast. He's the beast. They turned it around. Satan is a superhero that's coming back to save us, not the angel venom, disgusting of death. Angel of death that's coming back to kill people. He's coming back to save people, just like he did before. I mean, don't be confused if you hear someone calling him the venom of God. It's extreme malice and bitterness shown in someone's attitude or speech or actions towards someone. It's all that's going on. They hate me because they think they're going to come and tell me to change the original intent of blood over intent, the original intent. They're going to tell me that I have to sit here and change it because of what they believe.
Heaven on earth.
And it's ridiculous. That's the only reason they're calling him the venom of God. It's because of me. Because they want to, you know, torture me, brainwash me. I mean, you know, it's called passive aggression. Okay? Passive aggression. What is passive aggression? Indirectly expressing negative feelings instead of openly addressing them. And I can't talk to any of these people. I try, you know, they're not going to talk to me directly. They're just going to use this passive aggression over and over again just to try to make, you know, try to make, they don't, their venom, I'm immune to their poison. And I'm going to speak the truth no matter what. Someone is sexually harassing us right now. And it's all about, you know, I'm supposed to love everything and everyone. And you're not. That's why I did Blood Over Intent in the first place. Because I realized I'm in hell. And I decided I needed to do something about it. Okay? I decided I needed to do something about it. This person is still sexually harassing us. Nobody cares. And it's, you know, these people have formed a conspiracy to commit genocide to Blood Over Intent because they call themselves Christians. I don't really care. That's just what, I mean, this is, he thinks he's God. And he has the right to burn everyone. And you know, mentally torture people with this. I've seen a lot of people leave. I know it's affected a lot of people. Someone may have even committed suicide because of this. And it's, it couldn't be more disturbing. And the fact that these people think that they're going to tell me what to say and then, you know, change the original intent of Blood Over Intent and make me into this monster, which I really don't care. It just rolls off my back. I think it's ridiculous. But that's when you know it's either from ignorance or it's from malice. It's when there's hypocrisy. The 144,000 come back to get people who've made them come up for the sins. I'm telling how many we can get. That's why I've always wanted to be a superhero. Because that's what I understood from the beginning. To come back and release everyone from bondage. I don't care about this place and taking it over and destroying the moon, which you can't even do.
And release everyone
you know, you condemn the moon, things like the moon and Jesuits and the Pope, like the Pope's a mastermind. When Yahweh made the moon, Yahweh is the one that possesses the Jesuits and the Pope. And who did they commit genocide in the Albigensian Crusades and all the other crusades? Who did they do that in the name of? Yahweh. And that's another thing I'm being demonized for. But don't be confused, because I'm not going anywhere. And they're not going to run me off for sure. I mean, but to sit here
from bondage
and try to turn Satan into a killer who's coming to kill me and reprimand me. I don't need your reprimission to come and reprimand me and kill me because I don't agree with them. Couldn't be more sick. Turning family members against each other? Could you do anything more heinous? Whatever. You know, there's no rule that says I even have to know any of you people, man. If someone's calling Satan, trying to make Satan out to be the venom of God, that's nothing but a Jesuit, Catholic lie of hate. That's it. It's just their hate coming through, man, because they think they can tell other people what to believe and what to do. You know, just because I don't intend to benefit people who are trying to kill me and my family, and I'm actually doing something about it, is why we fell in the first place, because we didn't defend the Holy Spirit, Sophia, from Yahweh. That's why we fell in the first place, because we didn't do anything about it. That's why we're here. And I'm being demonized, singled out for it. And it's just disgusting, man. I really don't care. I don't even want to know you people that are doing that to me, man. And I don't have you either.
Stay in tonight. Skip the conversations and the oh, I'm fine. No, I'm no stranger to surprise. This paper town has let me down too many times. Why do I even try? Give me a reason why. I thought that I could trust you, never mind. Why are we switching sides? Where do I draw that line? I guess I'm too naive to read the signs. I'm just looking for some real friends. All they ever do is let me down. Every time I let somebody in, then I find out what they're all about. I'm just looking for some real friends. Wonder where they're all hiding out. I'm just looking for some real friends. Gotta get up out of this town. I stay up, talking to the moon. Been feeling so alone in every crowded room. Can't help but feel like something's wrong, yeah. Cause the place I'm living in just doesn't feel like home. I'm just looking for some real friends. All they ever do is let me down. Every time I let somebody in, then I find out what they're all about. I'm just looking for some real friends. Wonder where they're all hiding out. I'm just looking for some real friends. Gotta get up out of this town. Spell the names of all the dreams and demons for the times that I don't understand. Tell me what's the point of a moon like this when I'm alone again? Can I run away to somewhere beautiful where nobody knows my name? I'm just looking for some real friends. All they ever do is let me down. They need somebody in, but I find out what they're all about. I'm just looking for some real friends. All they ever do is let me down. I'm just looking for some real friends. Gotta get up out of this town, yeah.